Hi everyone, welcome to our NSTP subject. Today we're going to discuss the history and legal basis of NSTP. Okay, so let's start. Section 12 of Republic Act Number 9163, otherwise known as the National Service Training Program Act of 2001. The CHED, TESDA, and DND or Department of National Defense, in consultation with concerned government agencies, the Philippine Association of State Universities and Colleges, the Coordinating Council of Private Education Association of the Philippines, non-government organizations, and recognized student organizations hereby jointly issue, adopt, and promulgate the following implementing rules and regulations to implement the provisions of the Act. So basically speaking, ang Republic Act No. 9163 is known as the NSTP Act of 2001. So, kung tatanungin nyo, sir, pwede bang hindi namin kunin yung subject na NSTP sa college? Definitely, the answer is no. Why? It's because meron tayong legal basis. Okay, meron tayong batas na nagsasabi na kailangang i-offer ang subject na to sa college. Okay? And ano yung tatlong agencies na in charge dito sa NSTP? We have the CHED, TESDA, and Department of National Defense. Of course, with the help and consultation of other agencies. Nagigets? Okay. Okay, moving on to the next. National Service Training Program started with the passage of Commonwealth Act No. 1, also known as National Defense Act. Okay, so hindi agad-agad nag-start sa NSTP. So it all started with the National Defense Act. Ano naman ang purpose niya? To provide national defense of the country. So itong National Defense Act, na isa batas ito, okay, during the time of President Manuel Quezon. So, anong meron sa National Defense Act? It requires college students, specifically males, to finish 2 years or 4 semesters of military training to be reserve cadets of the national defense of the country. In August 8, 1980, the Commonwealth Act No. 1 was amended to give existence to Presidential Decree No. 1706 or National Service Law, which mandates compulsory national service to all citizens of the country. Okay, so from National Defense Act, nagkaroon ng changes because of Presidential Decree No. 1706, napalitan yung National Defense Act ng National Service Law. Ano naman ang purpose or ang objective ng National Service Law? It mandates compulsory national service to all citizens of the country. It is composed of 3 main component programs. Namely, Civic Welfare Service or the CWS, next, Law Enforcement Service or LES, and the Military Service. Okay, so basically speaking, there are 3 components of National Service Law, CWS, LES, and Military Service. So here, ang mga college students, they were given an option to choose among these 3 components to comply as a requirement of tertiary education. So, the students have the freedom to choose whatever components they prefer. Moving on to the next, after the ouster of President Marcos, the implementation of the National Service Law except the provisions of military service was suspended by Presidential Memorandum Order No. 1 of President Corazon C. Aquino. Okay, so nung nawala na sa pwesto si President Marcos, yung National Service Law ay na-suspend, okay, na-freeze, except yung isang component na military service. Nakukuha ba natin? So it became Basic Reserve Officer Training Corps or yung tinatawag nating ROTC that took effect on school year 1986 to 1987. On March 18, 2001, a dead body was found wrapped in a carpet and floating in the Pasig River. The face was wrapped in packing tape and the hands and face were bounded. The body was identified as Mark Welson Chua, 19-year-old engineering student from University of Santo Tomas, reportedly a victim of illegal ROTC practices, led to a massive protest of the college students and concerned parents against the ROTC program. Since then, expanded ROTC program morphed into National Training Service Program. Okay, so noong March 18, 2001, nagkaroon ng isang kadumal-dumal na krimen. Okay, so merong isang estudyante, a college student, na natagpo ang patay. So according to the investigation, biktima siya ng illegal ROTC program or yung mandated na ROTC program. Okay, so siya ay si Mark Wilson Chua. Ayan, so as you can see on this slide, yan ang kanyang itsura. Okay, so merong hashtag sa baba, no to mandatory ROTC. So, na-torture si Mr. Chua nung sumali siya sa ROTC. That is why the expanded ROTC program was amended, okay, napalitan siya, binago, into National Training Service Program. Okay, moving on to the rationale of the NSTP. The conceptualization and establishment of the NSTP for the tertiary level students is amended in the Republic Act 7077 and Presidential Decree Number 1706. This was enacted by the Senate and House of Representatives in Congress, which is known as the National Service Training Act of 2001. Ang tandaan nyo lang dito is yung Republic Act Number 9163. So what is the purpose of this program? Ano ba ang aim or ano ba yung objectives ng NSTP? NSTP is program aimed at enhancing the civic consciousness and defense preparedness in the youth by developing the ethics of service and patriotism, undergoing training in any of the three program components, especially designed to enhance the youth active contribution to the general welfare. So basically speaking, ang target ng NSTP ay mga kabataan, okay? Mga youth. Okay, to enhance their civic consciousness and defense preparedness. Okay, so let's start with the first component. We have the Literacy Training Service or the LTS. It refers to the program component designed to train the students to teach literacy and numeracy skills to school children, out-of-school youths, and other segments of society which are considerably need of their services. So sa LTS, basically, ang role ng mga students dito or ng mga kabataan is to teach literacy and numeracy skills to school children, out-of-school youths, and other people na need ng kanilang service. Okay, so parang ang role nila, magiging teacher din sila. Tuturuan nila yung mga bata, yung mga hindi nakapag-aral, yung mga nasa lansangan. Yun ang LTS. Okay, next we have the Civic Welfare Training Service. In this program, the students would undergo lectures and activities contributory to the general welfare and the betterment of life or the members of the community, and to render services, particularly the enhancement of instructional support materials and facilities in the following areas. So basically, sa CWTS, ang role dito is ma-attain natin yung betterment of our society. Okay? And then sa CWTS program kasi, meron niyang lectures, meron ding activities. That's why sa CWTS, dumadating sa time na nagkakaroon din ng immersion. Okay? Na isa rin sa mga activities sa CWTS. Okay? So ma-engage dito yung mga students, particularly dun sa real setup ng isang community. The goal of the CWTS is for the enhancement of instructional support materials and facilities in the following areas. So we have improving health, okay, yung health status, and then health condition ng isang community, the education, environment, entrepreneurship, safety, recreation, morale of the citizenry, and other social services. Okay, sabi ko kanina, it's for the betterment of a society or a community or the country in general. Okay, in the second semester, the students will undergo actual community service involvement. Ito yung sinabi ko kanina, okay, na merong community immersion sa CWTS. Projects and activities are designed to encourage the youth to contribute in the improvement of the general welfare and the quality life for the local community, applying various institutional components. Okay, so saan nakafocus ang teaching and learning? The teaching learning is focused in the development of the youth to become assets of the community, society, and to the nation as a whole, thus making them aware of their great role as individual to the development of the nation. Kabataan, okay, ang focus talaga nitong program na ito. Okay, just like Rizal, na si Rizal nga ang kanyang prinsipyo, naniniwala siya na ang kabataan ang pag-asa ng bayan. So kayo daw ang assets ng community, ng society, or in general, kayo ang asset ng ating bansa. Okay, so malaki ang roles ng bawat kabataan for the development of the country. The topics of activities to be considered would be nurturance of the importance and role of positive virtues, the attitudes and development of service-oriented characteristics individuals, as well as their responsibility towards mankind and the environment. The importance of CWTS as a whole is geared towards the development and redirection of positive values and attitude among students. Okay, so here in CWTS, you are given a chance to create a difference in your own ways, okay? You should appreciate your role and responsibilities not only as a student but also as an individual that can contribute to the betterment of life, okay? So, malaki ang tiwala sa inyo, okay, ng bansa. Kasi daw, meron daw kayong malaking impact, meron kayong magagawa for the betterment of this country. Okay, so that ends our lecture for Lesson 1, History and Legal Basis of NSTP. Thank you so much for listening. Have a good day ahead.